Bismillah Rahman Rahim. So we were here. We have read the first 2 points. Now we'll start at number three. Who wants to read? Raise our hand. Okay, Dr. Rizwana, read the point number three.
Okay. Ainal Gadaw. Where is the
lunch?
Lunch. Where is the lunch? Ainal Faturu. Where is the breakfast? Ainal Ashau. Where is the dinner? Ainal Fakihatu. Where are the fruits?
Where is the fruit?
Ainal Kahawatu. Where is the coffee?
In Arabic, the word faqiya is considered as singular word. Okay, who wants to read? Raise your hand.
You told me three and four.
Okay, Dr. Rizwana, read the point number four. Then Miss Amina will read the point number five and six.
La ta'kulu ta'ama.
When we use la nahiya. La preventive la, we la spoon with the verb. Okay, so you say la
ta'kuli.
Yes, la ta'kuli ta'ama. Okay,
la ta'kuli ta'ama. Don't eat food. La tashrabil haliba.
Don't drink.
La tashrabil haliba. Don't drink milk. La taknusil gurfata. Don't sweep the room. La taksilil malabisa. Don't wash the clothes. La tushahi dit tilfaza. Don't watch the television.
Next student. I think she's not available. Who wants to read? Raise her hand.
Assalamu alaikum. My mic was on. I'm off.
It's okay. Sorry. Continue now. Read the point number 5 and 6. Then Ms. Tassin, we read the point number 7 and 8. Start.
Thank you. Al-ghada'u ala al-ma'idati. The lunch is on the table.
Okay. Now you can say dining sheet also.
Pardon?
Dining sheet, you can say.
What's that?
Just like you have dining table in Arab countries and in Persia, in Pakistan, we have dining sheet that we separate on the floor.
Oh, okay. Alhamdulillah. Thank you. Okay. Al-fatooru ala al-ma'ida. The breakfast is on the table or the dining sheet. Al-asha'u ala al-ma'idati. The supper or the evening meal is on the table or the dining sheet. Al-fakihatu ala al-ma'idati. The fruit is on the table or the dining sheet. Al-qahwatu ala al-ma'idati. The coffee is on the table or dining sheet.
Continue.
ماذا تأكل في الفطور? What do you want to eat for breakfast?
Okay.
ماذا تأكل في الغداء? What do you want to eat for lunch? ماذا تأكل في العشاء? ashai, what do you want to eat for
here he is supper? Not saying what do you want, he is just asking what do you eat in breakfast, what do you
eat? I'm sorry, what do you eat? So like, what is your habit?
Yes, usual habit.
Okay, thank you.
Next student, Mr. Singh.
Yes. Mada tatlubu ta'ami?
Tatlubu
ta'ama.
Minat.
Mada tatlubu minat ta'ami? What do you want from the food? Mada tatlubu min ash-sharaba? This is for male.
Correct.
What do you want from the drink? Mada tatlubu min al-fakiha? Fakihati, what do you want from the fruit? Mada tatlubu min al-asasi? What do you want from the furniture? Do I read the feminine one?
Yes.
Mada tatlubina min al-ta'ami? What do you want from the food? Mada tatlubina min al-sharaba? Sharabi, what do you want? Sharabi, what do you want from the drink? Mada tatlubina min al-fakihati? What do you want from the fruit? Mada tatlubina min al-asasi? What do you want from the furniture?
Next, Mr. Sin.
Okay. Bada samaki min fadlik. Some fish, please. Bada aruzi min fadlik. Some rice, please. Bada salatati min fadlik. Some salad, please. Bada shay min fadlik. Some tea, please. Bada qahwati min fadlik. Some coffee, please.
Next time, inshallah, we'll continue Faham al-Musmu. Now, let's proceed to Holy Quran. Last time we read this. Who wants to read this now? Raise your hand. If anyone has any question regarding this, she can ask me now. Okay, no question. So, Ms. Tassin, you can read it.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألف لام ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين الذين يؤمنون بالغيب ويقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون والذين يؤمنون بما أنزل إليك وما أنزل من قبلك وبالآخرة هم يوقنون أولئك على هدى من ربهم وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ.
Ms. Tassin, had you prepared the word by word meaning for it?
Yes, I turned the homework already.
Okay, good. So, no, do it right now.
Oh, okay. From Bismillah? From Basmala?
Yes, start.
Okay. So, Bismi in the name of Allah, Labzul Jalal Allah, Ar-Rahman. I'm a little confused about Ar-Rahman. Ar-Rahim, the most merciful.
Ar-Rahman, the most beneficent.
Okay. Ar-Rahman, the most beneficent. Ar-Rahim, the most merciful. Alif Lam Mim, Huruf Al-Muqatta'at. So we don't know their meaning. Zalika, that. Al-Kitabu, the book. La, no. Raiba, doubt. Fihi, in it. Hudan, guidance. Lil muttaqin, for muttaqin people, the pious. Alladina, those. Yu'minuna, they believe. Bil ghaib, in the hidden.
Unseen.
Wa yuqimuna, they establish. As-salata, prayer, the prayer. Wamimma, from what? Razaqnahum. They are provided.
Razaqnahum. Razaq mean provision. Na mean we. Hum mean them. The provision we have provided them.
The provision we have provided them. Yunfiqoon, they spend. Wa and alladina, those yu'minuna, they believe. Bima, in what? Unzila, revealed.
Is sent ilayka. Down. Unzila means sent down.
Okay. Unzila, sent down. Ilayka, ilayka, to you, upon you.
Okay.
Wa and, I'm sorry, what?
To you, okay.
To you. Wama, and what? Unzila, sent down. Min, from? Qablika, before you.
Okay, here wa, the min is harfe zayda according to Arabic grammar. There you will study the harfe zayda later on in the third volume of Durusul Lughatil Arabiyya. Inshallah, we will study that book also.
Okay.
So you will study about harf zayda in that book.
Okay, min harf zayda.
And we will not use it in translation, okay?
In translation, okay. So, qablika, before you, wa and bil akhirati, the day of judgment.
Bil akhirati, in the hereafter. Hereafter means in the next hereafter. Life.
Okay, in the hereafter. Hum, they, yuqinun, believe. And this belief is like certainty, right?
Yes.
You said certainty?
Okay. They have a firm belief, okay?
Firm belief.
Okay.
Ulaika, those, ala, upon, hudan, guidance, min, from, rabbihim, their lord, wa, and ulaika, those, whom they, al-muflihun, are successful. They are successful.
Who are successful, okay. So here we learn the qualities of muttaqi people. So the first quality, Mr. Sin, tell me the qualities of muttaqi people according to these ayat.
So number one, they believe in the unseen.
Okay.
They establish prayer.
Number two, okay.
Number three, they spend from what is provided to them.
Okay.
They believe in Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Number four, okay.
Number five, they believe in the prophets that came before him sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And number six, they have firm belief in the hereafter.
Okay, so these are the six qualities of muttaqi person, okay. So here you see they have used many colors. So today we'll just look at the orange color. Whenever you see any letter written with orange color, this means it is madda letter. So there are three madda letters in Arabic. Waw madda, alif madda, and ya madda. So whenever you see any letter written with the orange color, you need to hold it. Like lil muttaqeen. Yunfikun. So you need to hold the letter which is written with wow color, with orange color. Yuqinun humul muflihun, like this. Okay. Anybody, any question?
Sir, yunfikun.
Yunfikun, they spend. Yunfikun mean they spend, okay? Anyone who wants to read this one? Okay, Miss Fatu Bintu Kamara. Read it.
الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله in the name of Allah Ar-Rahman, the most beneficent, Ar-Rahim, the most merciful. Alif Lam Mim, those are the letters, we don't know their meaning. Dalika, that Al-Kitab, book, the Quran, La Raib, no doubt, fihi in it, hudan, guidance, lil muttaqin, for the pious. Alladina, those yu'minuna, who believed bil ghaibi, in the unseen, wa yuqimuna, and they established as-salata, prayers, wa mimma, and what razaqnahum, we have provided.
What is the meaning?
And what?
From what? It is composed of two words. First word is min and second is ma. Mimma, from what?
Okay. Wa mimma, from what? Razaqnahum, we have provided for them. Yunfiqoon, they spend. Walladhina, and those yu'minuna, who believe bima, in what unzila, we send down ilayka, to you, wama, and what unzila, we have sent.
Was sent down. Unzila, was sent down. This is fi'li majrur. In fi'li majrur, we don't know who is the subject.
Okay.
Was sent down.
Okay. Wama, and what unzila, was sent down. Min qabilika, before you,
wa
bil akhirati, and in the hereafter, whom they yuqinun, they believe firmly. Ulaika, these ala are on hudan, guidance, min rabbihim, from their Lord. Wa ulaika, and these whom they al muflihun are the successful ones.
Okay, ulaika mean those. Ulaika, those are the one who are successful. Okay. Anybody, any question?
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
I think I heard you use a word to describe the huruf at the beginning. I understand that it's not something that we should spend time understanding the precise meaning of, but you used a word to describe the huruf. Mukatta or something?
Okay, we call them huruful mukattiat.
Mukattiat?
Yes.
What does that mean?
There are some words in the Holy Quran and we don't know their meaning. These are called huruful muqatti'at. Okay, first thing. But if we look at the poetry in the pre-Islamic period, we will find some poetic verses at the start of which they have also used some word like these, similar to these huruful muqatti'at.
Yes, I understand about that. My question more relates to the word muqatti'at. I don't know what that word itself in Arabic means.
What is your question? I could not understand your question.
The word muqatti'at, what does muqatti'at mean?
Okay, muqatti'at. We use muqatti'at for those words whose meaning we don't know. Okay?
Okay, so that word muqatti'at is only ever used for those letters. It's not used in Arabic elsewhere?
In Arabic, it is used for another thing which means section.
Okay. So we keep it separate.
Yes.
Okay, I think I understand. Yes. Okay, thank you.
Good.
Thank you.
So how to write that muqatti'at?
Okay, let me write it for you.
Yeah, so that I can write meaning.
Do you see the whiteboard?
Yeah.
Muqatti'at. So muqatti'at means section.
Muqatti'at.
But in
this term, stop.
Muqatti'at. Yes, muqatti'at.
Muqatti. So it is ta.
Ta. Mim, kaf, ta, ain, alif, ta.
Kutiyat.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
I have another question related. Now that I see it written, so qata'a.
Yes.
Qata'a, the root qata'a.
Okay, you are asking the root word, okay? Am I right?
Yes. Well, is it qata'a?
Qat'un. The root word is always ism, not fail. Qata'a is a verb, is a fail, but the root qat'un. Word is qat'un.
Okay, thank you.
We have tanween, okay? Qat'un.
Qat'un. Which, so if that's an ism, what does that mean?
Cut.
Cut.
Ah, yes. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Sweet. Alhamdulillah. And related to the term yunfiqoon, they spend.
Yes.
Can we understand that meaning also to say to use? So we use our provision?
Yunfiqoon.
But you have choices about how we use it?
Sorry, do you have any kind of choices? How do you use it?
Yes, like, because it says they spend.
Yes. Okay. In Islam.
Can we also understand? Sorry.
In Islam, in the word yunfikun, for example, here the quality is written that yunfikun, they spend. So now this spend is for anything good. Okay. For example.
So that includes zakat?
Zakat, optional donation, everything. For example, let me give you an example. And then many people think that the money we give to poor, from that we get reward only. But if you have a child, you spend something for him, then that thing is also in this category. Anything good, for anything good you spend, it will be in this category. Okay?
Yes, so my question was about, when we try to understand these verses nicely, to have some meaning for ourselves.
Yes.
I understand it means they spend. So in English, we would say, how do we use our wealth? What do we use it for? Okay. So can we use it in the sense of use?
Yes, you can use it. Okay. Just like you can use it for anything good.
Use it for benefit.
Yes.
Right.
Even your own benefit.
Alhamdulillah. Yes. Alhamdulillah.
Okay.
Alhamdulillah.
Yes.
Jazakumullah khair.
And even if we spend something on our children, we will get a reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for spending that.
Yes.
So that is like sadaqah.
Yes, sadaqah. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said that even the food that you put on your wife's mouth, that is also a sadaqah for you. Which means you will also get reward from that. Anyone else? I think no question. So we will stop here. And inshallah, next time we'll continue from here, okay?
Jazakumullah khair.